Understand nature, you can miss God's voice. God's voice is in nature. That's why he says, go to the ant, thou sluggard, consider her ways and be wise. God tells us to go to insects to hear his voice. If he tells us to go to the ant, how much can we go to the bird or the hippo or the elephant or the lion? This is why he shows us these animals in dreams, because what is he doing? He is trying to get us to learn his voice through parabolical symbols. So for years, I never got that. I said, this is how Joseph knew this man was gonna die, because he knew how birds operate. They only are over the head of something they're about to eat, because it's gonna die. What do you think about that?
God is amazing that he would speak to us like this. And I'm just, as you're sharing, Apostle, I'm just considering how much have we neglected over the years, because we didn't understand this. You know, like we saw the Lord restore the apostle and the prophet, those offices back in the, you know, the 70s, 80s, and 90s, and how much we missed out as the church. But now he's restoring the office of the dreamer. Everything you just unveiled, we would have never known that. These truths, unless God is restoring this office. And we know that the Lord appeared to you to restore this office and give you the revelation. And I mean, who would have thought that? How many dreams have we had that we missed God? And what was Abraham Lincoln supposed to do with the rest of his life? But he didn't, because it was cut short from a lack of a dream officer in their life.
Yes.
But thank God, you know, like that man had Joseph in his life, or the two did, and for Pharaoh to save the whole nation.
He saved the whole nation. And yes, that's what Job talks about, a dream officer. It says, if there be a messenger with him. That if gives, that is a very broad term, and it gives you a choice to have success or failure. If there be a messenger with him, who shall show unto him his righteousness, the Lord's righteousness. That's in Job. If there be a dream officer or an interpreter, that's what it says. If there be an interpreter with him, he shall show unto him his way, one among a thousand. And so the Bible says there's, God anoints every one person among a thousand people to be a dream officer. Did you know that? And my question to you, are you a dream officer? Are you one among a thousand people? Number two, you may not be a dream officer. Do you have the gift of dreams? How often do you dream? Is God speaking to you at all in dreams? It is very important, because that's one way God communicates with you. And if you wake up and start just saying, oh, I saw these symbols, this is crazy, this is whatever, you will never understand what God is saying. Because the way things are in the natural is not all the way what God is saying in a parabolical form. I remember another dream I had, and in this dream, and I'm gonna give you another revelation here. In the dream, I had an earring in my ear, and y'all gotta understand how hard I preached against men wearing earrings. You know, back when I was a child, only gay people wore earrings, you know what I'm saying? And now all these guys wearing earrings, so they think it's cool. I still don't think it's cool. I think it's gay anyway, you know. You know, I don't believe a man should wear no earrings. So I'm in a dream, and I have an earring on, and I'm going up an elevator, and I'm saying, wait a minute. When I wake up by that dream, I'm like, God, you're not showing me I'm going to turn and start doing some stupid worldly stuff. Because see, you can wake up out of a dream and your natural mind can get in the way because you don't understand. Until you have an interpreter, until you study. And this is why I put together so many books on dreams. I want you to learn, because it can save your life. It can save your business. It can save your family, your marriage. So I wake up out of that dream and I'm like, Lord, what did that mean? And I had enough training to know, don't ever believe what you see in the dream out of your own mind. So I said, Lord, what did it mean? He says, go through the pattern that I've taught you. Now, I'm going to show you how I learned the pattern of this. So one of the things that I was just saying is that when I woke up out of that dream, and thank you, musicians, I was so terrified, actually, because I had preached so hard against men wearing earrings. And I'm thinking, Lord, is my heart changing or something? But that ain't what God means. And so the Lord says to me, he says, go through the process I showed you. Now, let me teach you what that means. So whenever I have a dream, right, there are certain books in the Bible that you can interpret almost 8 to 90% of any dream you have.